So what is the scope of social policy? Social policy is called a magpie subject. Magpie is a bird which is which steals eggs or nests of other birds. So social policy is a subject that depends on the research, on the techniques of other disciplines. And many economists and political scientists are actually studying social policies. So they may not call themselves the experts in social policy, but they are actually looking, they are social policy experts. The difference between an economist studying social policy and a political scientist studying social policy will be, quite substantial. But in the end, their research will be part of the social policy literature. So now we look at how different subjects interact or add up or help or assist the social policy research. So anthropology, which is a discipline which looks at how people live. It's the study of human culture. So how does anthropology relate to social policy? So anthropology is basic studies kinship, the relationship between different people. It looks at family, it looks at household composition, and this research, anthropological research, then adds up to social policy, because social policy is concerned about services. So how many people are present in a, for example, social policy is concerned about housing. So how many people live in, usually what's the size of a family, usual family size in Pakistan? That is important when you are thinking of how providing housing, whether it's okay to provide one bedroom house or two bedroom house. So that will be decided based on anthropological research. Geography, the spatial patterns of will be decided by on the basis of geographical research. So we talked about water. So where the water is coming from, in which areas, whether it's an area which has 10 inch rainfall or 20 inch rainfall or 50 inch rainfall. These things will be, or this information or research will be provided by geography, and then on the basis of that research or data, we will come up with a social policy, which is water policy. Philosophy. What's the basis of social policy? Why we are concerned about social policy? We are concerned about social policy because we want to provide services to all the people. Why all the people? Because all people are basically equal. Who said that? This was decided by the philosophers. We decided among human philosophy over 1,000 or 2,000 years have come up with, agreed that all people, irrespective of their ethnic or religious origins, they are equal. So the social services provided to them should be equal. So philosophy adds up. So if a country now decides that people are, for example, Israel or some other country decides that some people are better or more important than the other people, then its social policy will be different. And because it comes from a different philosophical, basis. Psychology. So you are thinking of stopping people from smoking. So how do you stop that? You increase the tax rate on cigarettes. How will it help? Because people don't want to spend more. This is in their psychology. So psychological research enters into social policy. Statistics, of course, statistics is essential ingredient of social policy. We cannot make evidence-based policy unless we have this different, we have data and we have statistical analysis of this data. If we make decisions or make policies without statistical analysis, they will be most likely inefficient and ineffective. Biology, again, family, living conditions, gender, all these things are related to biology and they enter into social policy. History, we look at history of social policies adopted in developed countries and see how their effect is, and then adopt policies based on the evolution of those policies. Political economy, we look at how politics and economy interact and affect social policies. So all these different disciplines which I have discussed, and there are many more, affect social policies. So we cannot come up with a social policy, effective social policies, without looking at all the research of all these disciplines. Thank you.